go into game number one right now, the SBL, and we've got Dave and Trelly to do it.
Let's delay no further. It's Leviathans and Ravens.
Yeah, it's been a lot of, hey, let's try and kill supports. If we can't, we're going to pull a relic. That is what's happening. Haddix, though, does get trapped in, and here's a big rotation over coming for the Guan Yu.
Ooh, Haddix, that's a decent dash. Avoids a lot of the burst from the potion. Not really being worked down, and that potion didn't do all that much.
He is so
healing fine. And sustain will feel a-okay for this Guan Yu, and Haddix is actually maybe never under that much threat. Instead, it's adapting, burned by Scream, and there's your first blood in Season 10 of the Smite Pro League, and it's a Highland Ravens jungler, Scream on Anubis, notching the first kill.
Yeah, Haddix makes the rotation over and wants to start this one up. Everyone's here, but it looks like adapting's
wow,
over,
quick.
Right? Fino's gone. That's free.
That is free. Highland Ravens, in a lot of these early matches, are going to be us figuring out exactly the playstyle these teams like. Scream, we know what he likes to do, and it's step forward. Might get pulled back in, and this is where the Leviathans could fight back. Shinto answers an early kill with one of his own, and Ven's being chased down, but adapting didn't have enough damage, and it might just be the one kill over in mid. Scream just got a bit too aggressive.
They're looking towards the Pyromancer. Final K still has a cage locked and loaded. If someone steps up, possibly for a hurry win or anyone else behind. Everyone's decently tanky, but it looks like they might have the burst for this one.
There's your cage. This is where the Leviathan Zap tries to steal it, actually, at the end there. Shinto, a good last couple of minutes. Picks up two kills and a couple of mid lane fights, and suddenly the Leviathans roar right back into game one. A Pyromancer, a Runic Bomb, all theirs for the taking.
Very true. I think this team as a whole, I guess the core of it, has had issues in that department. Shinto has to use the Aegis. He's going to get...
Oh!
There was three charges on that Baba. Ven was locked and loaded on that one. I did not expect that much damage. To the Guan, you'd either have to go back to base or look for some trouble. Now, Barra, beautiful block.
What a read. Adapting reads the backflip, and that should be enough for a kill onto Barracuda. His life delayed a bit. Now, can Haddix chase down the return kills? That man's starting to swing a bit. Here at the 17-minute mark, out of his support's ultimate he goes, but Haddix still on the chase forward. Ven's got value, and Ven's got two, and a double kill on left. Leviathans overstay. They get a tower, but they lose their duo lane.
And that should be the end of the scrapping so far. Once again, though, a Fury pulled where Final K is nowhere to be seen.
The value that Baba Yaga gets on Prophetic. 8 stacks for Shinto. And so, you know, the conversation is, Trelly, is Pyromancer pulled by the Ravens, maybe close by are the Leviathans. Wrong use attempted a steal. And I don't know who got it, but someone
Shinto
did from the Leviathans. Must have been Shinto with the Baba Yaga damage. And the Ravens, they want to make him pay. It'll be a chase down. Into the house goes Shinto. Just about everything gets used, and this Baba Yaga survives. But only barely, because the Ravens and Barracuda have damage on the back end. But look at this five-man grouping from the Highland Ravens, really dispelling anyone from the Leviathans attempting to step
Definitely
forward.
An attempt at Fire Giant. Maybe the Leviathans aren't quite on it yet.
Yeah, Ravens have picked it up. Wrong Yu steps forward. Half HP
it's
on
gone.
The FG. Adapting close. Final K in, and the Leviathans steal away another objective. Final K may trade his life for it. In fact, he'll stay alive. It's disastrous for the Highland Ravens, and now the fight after the fact with the Leviathans' carries finally arriving may look good, and it's hurry win left behind. One bit of burst healing from Haddix maybe keeps the support in the fight. Riptide enough for now.
Wrong Yu and adapting, though, they have the cutoff. They don't have ultimates, but they have plenty of damage. Surely Hurrywind has to fall here, but it looks like they don't want to go in just yet. They're fearful of Ven's damage.
Another good Riptide out. That keeps Hurrywind on the map, and it looks like teams disengaging. What a moment. Another one for the Leviathan.
That spotted out immediately, just charging up a stun, trying to see what he can find. Misses the opportunity. And he's going to find a cage, but it's only on Haddix.
It is on Haddix, and Haddix unconcerned. Hurrywind answers with the River's Rebuke of his own. Zapman with the first of the fight. Now the Leviathans step forward, but the Ravens will take a double step back. Should be a simple FG pull now, but the Ravens sensing that their opportunities in game one, weaning a bit.
Dapping behind.
Dapping with a rotation through, knocks Scream aside. He's gone big, and two taps Scream. Ven flips the damage, but it might not matter. The Leviathans have dropped the Fire Giant, and instead looking for the chase. Ven on beads, and Final K and Zapman will look for a right side bird with just Barra and Ven on the map.
Got some good damage, but that Phoenix is dropping slowly. It's up to Barra, and it looks like the call is give that bird up. It's not that worth it. you're only losing the Phoenix unless they decide to go for the end call. Final K's backing. Tells me a teleport might have came through, but I think Rongyu takes too much damage. Smart call here from the Levi's. Grab that Phoenix and try and
retreat. Tied though from Hurrywind.
They're giving it up.
And now, after all that dancing and foot tapping around the enhanced fire, Giant the Raven simply cannot be asked. They will step away. And the EFG, after 5+ minutes of looking at it, goes to the
Final Levi. K could essentially solo this Phoenix if given the opportunity. Right side minions are already down.
He might just cage everyone if they all step forward.
He's got the opportunity to. He's in trouble now.
He does drop a cage, but there's a River's Rebuke as an answer. Phantom Shell used by the Leviathans. Haddix gets pulled back in on a stun, but there's not enough burst damage to deal with the Guan Yu. And if the Leviathans play cautiously, as they have, you wonder how concerned they are about the front lines both being half HP, adapting on a split push, but Scream is there to answer. Fine, okay, jumps away. For Zapman as well. If a fight were to break out, could be a game-ending fight. Still enhanced Fire Giant. Fine, okay, adapting there forward. Scream! Crit by adapting! And Fine, okay, is not traded out. Left side Phoenix an afterthought. And the Leviathans off a stolen Fire Giant earlier in the game have some wind in their sails. Mid Phoenix also gone.
They got a fight now.
Element, though. From the Highland Ravens around behind the Leviathans, but does that just deliver a fight to Finokay? For now, yes. Finokay uses the cage. There is plenty of damage from the carries. The Odin cage and a lot of health from Finokay gone. Shinto over the wall pokes down some damage. On to the Ravens, and Scream has finished off a kill onto the Odin. And is this the call that gets the Ravens back into the game? That delete zap! Wrong you, Shinto left running, adapting with a solo mission in behind the
Titan.
Ravens. Trades off onto Scream, fire minions pouring into the base. The Titans
Adapting's
down to
going
half
for
HP,
it.
Adapting into the base. But it looks like some backs have been completed. Wrong you, detonated by Ven, and Adapting will be held at bay.
If Adapting had ultimate, maybe he goes for that couple without it, and that's not the play. Shinto is still sticking around.
The Titan
here
is so low, Haddix desperately clinging to life
Shinto
here in game number
one. Shinto is still here.
Shinto never left the fight and is now hanging around the EFG. It's miracle territory now for the Baba Yaga.
Final
K into the fight once more. Drops a cage. Can Shinto and Final get it done? EFG, it's slowed down. The damage not on it. And the Ravens get the Fire Giant after a fight envelopment wraparound that worked well. But the base solo on the Highland Ravens side of the map. The Leviathans may just need one more push.
And here comes Adapting. He's falling deep, but Bear's got the damage. Fine, okay. He's getting ripped through, and the Lightning Storm is going to have enough damage.
Oh, my God, but has Ven stepped too far forward? He has. Barracuda on a double. One more swing for a triple, and the Aegis wears out.
But
Zapman stands his ground, kills off both carries for the Highland Ravens. And the Titan, it is low, but it is not reset. The health is still there. Back and forth we go in game one of season 10 of the Smite Pro League. Either squad, depending on initiation, on pick, could find themselves the winners in game number one. Shinto, Riptided back twice by Hurrywind, and Rongyu is as well. It's three Riptides back from the Raven's support, but Rongyu lives. Rongyu lives. Haddix gets burned down while trying to finish off the kill. He'll dash away once more. It's a leap forward. Adapting doesn't have the damage, but he uses his ultimate. It's a chase through from the Highland Ravens. Now you got this low health
Lightning
target.
Storm.
Detonate used, but doesn't finish off. Scream kills off Rongyu, and finally a pick for the Ravens after plenty of damage.
That was quite the long fight, only to get one kill.
EFG is burning.
Fine, okay. He's here. More magic for the Leviathans necessary. You do not have your support. You've got range. You've got the ability to poke. Fire Giant, it's slow though. The Ravens kind of half commit to it, and the Ravens full commit and get EFG. The Leviathans still missing their support, but a chase down from the Ravens. We will now see the first real big opportunity for siege from the Ravens.
It already is. And it looks like they're just going to siege forward.
That's right. When I say costly, I mean it already is because you lose the EFG, but you could lose your Phoenix as well. Can the Leviathans afford to really step forward here? You might lose the game if too many of your teammates go down. Give you an advantage. Somebody from the Leviathans has to go clear those minions. You're not hyper worried about them just yet, however. It's a 5v5 underneath the Phoenix. Rongyu starts us off, pulls Haddix right back in. Hurrywind bails out his solo laner with the River's Rebuke, but Shinto's alone. He stepped forward, and a detonate will not get it done. Left side bird gone.
Last couple of sieges, though. Rongyu was dead for one of them.
Now the fight begins. Barracuda left on the front line. Rongyu pulling back in Hurrywind, but does not find the stun with his ultimate. Detonate damages down. One more Riptide. Why not? Maybe icing on the cake for the Highland Ravens, who want to get out of this game at 53. Double kill for Venn. He's got nearly 50k damage. And the Leviathan's on a 5v3. That's got to do it. Unless there can be a miracle, some magic from Zapman adapting in Fine OK. But the rest of the Ravens, unconcerned. One more step forward, and the ball ends up in the net, and the Ravens take game one.
We'll see what Scream can do here in the early game, and well, whether or not it'll go all the way to 50 again as we jump into game number two, the Ravens and the Leviathans.
Man, both Attic, Scylla will survive for now. Against Fine OK. Shinto flickers away, doesn't matter. Venn, first blood.
Now they want to get active, and it looks like maybe over on right lane, because here comes the rest of the Leviathans.
It's going to be an initial 3v2 for the Levi's, but then a slower rotation in from Hurrywind, a slower rotation in from Shinto. A good fight for the Leviathans, and the first kill of the game for the Levi's goes to the Merlin. But there's more after the fact. Haddix is stuck around in this fight, and Haddix has answered one. Despite it being an odd-numbered engagement, a stun onto adapting, feeds one to Venn. And what looked like a great start to a fight ends up being 2-for-1 in favor of the Ravens.
Back in with life of the party and Fine OK. Use that to send him out as it just gets him more damage. Oh, but no. Shinto now is the target of aggression.
Does a lot of damage. Yeah, that'll be enough for Scream. The Ravens starting to roll. Remember, the Ravens had control of game
level deficit, but what that really tells you is Zapman has felt just fine over in duo.
Man, it's a worrying trend now here, Trelly. Things just starting to come a bit undone for the Atlantis Leviathans. You have such a good opportunity over on left.
A lot of damage. Steps forward. Could be a coin flip. And actually, Scream using ult. That's enough to just send the Leviathans right back. Adapting will be stunned by Venn.
Dropkicked by Scream. And smacked against the wall. Another one for the Ravens.
Now it's Gold Fury looked at by the Ravens. Leviathans pulled it a moment ago. Scream separated him from it.
Three members of the Leviathans, though, rotating over. Zapman a chance to steal. Comes up just short. This is a good ultimate from Rongyu. Four members of the Ravens slowed down on their disengage. Beads have to get used. Fine, okay. On a rotation out of solo. This could be a moment for the Cthulhu, but it's a runaway from the Highland Ravens. Adapting dashes forward. Does not have ultimate. Still waiting for it to come back out. And as such, Fine OK has just been left alone because Haddix is here and he is swinging. The cavalry charge, though, puts him right into the lion's den. But the lions will go hungry. The Ravens grab gold and get out alive all five.
Up.
I don't think so.
Maybe
he's stepping forward.
Steps forward. Drop kicked away. Beads used. A flicker. Probably needed here. That gets sent up as well. Scream, a slight backstep, getting all of the relics away from the Leviathans. You'll still call that a win, except for Scream, who's been left alone. Here's your double colossal team fight from the Leviathans, and maybe a stun from Zap, but Hurrywind out of range. That's where being too aggressive can bite
your chances.
Runic Bomb picked up by Hurrywind on a quiet Pyromancer fight, but in go the Ravens out of nowhere. Blink and you miss it. And I miss Shinto in this fight at all. Rongyu does not have ult. And therefore, no chance. Zapman dove by Haddix as well. And Haddix can just keep going. Doesn't have cavalry charge. And Zapman, the Charybdis, will get out alive just fine. 18-minute FG for the Highland Ravens as Fine OK steps forward and attempts to steal.
Fine OK does have a send to madness here soon. He's not going to burn down quick, but it's just going to be a steal attempt as Haddix is falling a little bit low here. Adapting goes into the Fury.
Might be a kill traded back. Haddix indeed falls. Fire Giant goes to the Ravens. A Runic Bomb used, and that might have been a difference maker just to get the confirm.
More consistent, but maybe his ceiling was a bit lower. That's sort of the conversation you're looking at with Hurry.
Hurry's had a pretty high ceiling in this set so far, but he's the one who's going to take the journey to the party. We'll live for now. Fine OK chasing forward. Adapting is going to find the back line as well, but Scream is scrapped out so effectively. Zapman steps forward and Barret deletes him. But Fine OK, with one last swing in the fight, has flipped things right back. Shinto has been under pressure since minute one, and it won't change at minute 20. 1-5 on the Merlin, and the Ravens not done yet.
They want to push it. So they can't clear these waves. Fine OK can step up. That's a 21-minute Phoenix.
Gotta take it. Should save the Phoenix. He does, but a stiff breeze knocks it over. That means the fight breaks out on right. Fine OK, no chance. Barracuda lets him know about it.
Wrong you in the river's rebuke lets the waters crash over him.
Yep. It should be all three Phoenixes down, and barring a massive play here from Adapting. He's got Colossal.
Look at Haddix. He's going behind here. He's got Cavalry Charge coming back up shortly, and he's going to make his presence known real soon.
They know. I'm not sure they even knew he was back there. That was an awkward rotation from Haddix to answer. If you're the Leviathan, Shinto simply having to dance around. A flicker away and a Cavalry Charge. The carry's left running from the Leviathans, and it's simply Haddix getting it done, and an Aegis off of Zapman as well. It's a one-man army in the back line. Really in back-to-back games, but Leviathans made some plays in Game 1 that they were not able to replicate in Game 2. The Ravens, Venn, Vera, Haddix make some changes on the roster, and at least in Game 1 of Season 10, Set 1 of Season 10, things looking wonderful for this team. Final K, Riptide it back in once more. No kills rolling through for the Ravens, and the Titan hasn't taken any damage. And actually, Zapman with a kill onto Venn made this Titan siege a bit more awkward. I'm not sure. Highland Ravens liking their chances much more. You may need to wait for another 45.
Ravens are just sticking around. Right, it looks side like bird. Right, whoa, side Zap. Bird is what they want. Zapman should be just fine, but Vera dashes
in.
Oh,
the double Riptide! Hello, Hurrywind! And welcome back to the SPL. The Leviathans lose their mid laner, and now the game may be broken. But Barracuda, he's got two frontliners looking at him, and they don't have enough damage. A dropkick away from Scream. Zapman Riptides forward. A killing spree for Barra is how he'll end this game, unless Final K has the last bit of damage. And he does, but a double kill from Barra might seal the deal. And the Titan gets jumped on by the Ravens. A 2-second respawn from Adapting, and a 2-0 for the Highland Ravens.